Today we're going to focus on the banking section of the command center. The main part of any of these sections is the actual register for that section. In this case, the bank register. And from here we would choose which bank we wanted to focus on. And we'll just pick checking account from here, but you certainly could pick any of these other accounts that are set up as bank accounts, including your credit card, by the way, which can be set up and reconciled just as a regular bank account can. If I wanted to select a period of time for my transactions, I could get a better understanding where my money is gone, and I can also drill down and look at a particular transaction and get the detail of that transaction. And I can also go to the journal for that particular transaction, and it allows me a lot of flexibility to research any particular problem I might have. Now, also, keep in mind that when you use the spend money, you are not paying bills from here that were entered into accounts payable. If you enter a bill and pay a bill, rather, from this spend money that has already been entered into accounts payable, you will be effectively doubling your expense in your general ledger, and that would be improper accounting. So keep that in mind. If you already have an accounts payable entered, you do not want to use the spend money section. For that, you will go into purchases and you will pay bills. Also, in the banking section of the command center, you will see receive money. Once again, as with spend money, you do not want to get a cash receipt that relates to anything that has to do with a sales invoice that you might have entered in. So for sales invoices, you're going to use the sales section and receive payments against the invoices that you already have in your accounts receivable. So receive money section would be used for any kind of miscellaneous money that you might have received. It's also good for recording interest income, for instance. It could be a refund check or a tax refund or anything other than an invoice from a sale. Here you can also prepare electronic payments. And for that, you would need to set up a service. And what that would allow you to do is have MYOB, direct deposit and vendor payments, enabled, and it will allow you to basically make payments electronically to your vendors. We're going to skip that now because this is a service that you need to set up directly with MYOB. Here you can actually print checks. Now these checks are on this list because when you went to write a check in the first place, from spend money, for instance, you selected to be printed. And when you select to be printed, it essentially sits in a queue and will allow you to print that check either one at a time or as many checks as you need to. You can print the whole check run at one time. Also, you can send out email notifications if you would like for all or just one of the vendors that you want to pay. With that, you would need to have the email information set up for that particular vendor for them to get a notification that you're actually paying them, whether that be by a regular check or an electronic payment.